That one are you able to complete? Annette? Aditya? Logarithm, is it clear? How to take log? How to take anti-log? Is it okay? Any doubts do you have? Aparna? Anila Mohanan? Tell me, Anila? Yes? Yes, any doubts are there? Anila Mohanan?
No, I wasn't into the first.
Yes?
I was not in, there in the first step.
First, okay. Okay, is it clear for you how to take log and all?
Yes, ma'am.
Anti-log?
Yes, ma'am.
What about Annette? We are going to start with the next chapter. That's what I'm asking. The previous class, the headset is not working and I'm not able to understand whether you are able to do that one or. Aishwarya, Aishwarya, is it okay? Any doubts in logarithms?
No, ma'am.
Aditya, Satyan, Karthik? Tomlin?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay, shall we start with the next chapter?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Shall we start with the next chapter? Write the heading, that's an easy one. Mathematical reasoning. Okay, mathematical reasoning. Is mathematical reasoning. Going to discuss about mathematical reasoning. Okay, reasoning you might have heard, isn't it? What about reasoning? Mathematical reasoning means relay. Okay, Max. Okay, mathematical reasoning. What can you tell me? What is meant by reasoning? Okay, usually this Max and English, they are more connected. In probability also we use and. Or, isn't it? Based on the word we are using, and, or means we select the operator. Okay, if it is and, we use into, or means we select or, addition. Okay, so how it is connected and all we are going to learn. Okay, reasoning, how the English language is connected with Max. That's what we are going to learn in this topic, mathematical reasoning. Okay. You are familiar with the sentences. In English, you will be learning what is sentence. What is a sentence? What is a sentence? What is a sentence? What is a sentence?
Meaningful set of words.
Meaningful set of words. Okay, here you are going to learn about statements, mathematical statements. Is the board clear, children? What I am showing here, is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so we are going to learn with statements. What is a statement? Okay, the basic unit involved in mathematical reasoning is a. So in mathematical reasoning, the important component, important part is mathematical statement. Look at the statement. Look at the first statement. In 2003, the president of India was a woman. An elephant weighs more than a human being. These are some statements, isn't it? In 2003, the president of India was a woman. What will be your answer? Now, in 2020, the president of India was a woman. Is it true? Is it correct? What is your answer? In 2003, the president of India was a woman. Is it correct? Okay, not take 2020. The president of India was a woman. What you will say? What will be your answer?
No.
No, you'll say no, isn't it? Isn't it? You'll be saying it no. Why? We know it is a man, isn't it? Who is the president? Who is the president? Anila Mohanan. Who is the president of India? Aishwarya. Yes? Karthik? Yes, you are not reading the newspapers, that's the thing. Annette?
Ramnath Kovind.
Yes, Ramnath Kovind. Okay, so we know that he's a man. So surely we will say no, isn't it? Now look at the second statement. An elephant weighs more than a human being. What will be your answer? Is it correct or no? We will say it is wrong or it is correct, isn't it? There is exactly one answer for that question. If there is only one answer, then we say it is a statement. For example, suppose I am saying like this. Listen, children, you can read afterwards. Now listen. Tomorrow is Saturday. Tomorrow is Saturday. This is a sentence, but it is not a mathematical statement. Why? Tomorrow is Saturday. If I say it today, what will be your answer? It is wrong, isn't it? You will be saying no, isn't it? If I say the same sentence tomorrow, what you will say? Tomorrow is Friday. Tomorrow I will say, tomorrow is Saturday. What you will do? You'll be saying yes. Is or no? If I say today, today we know that today is Thursday. And if I say tomorrow Saturday, tomorrow is Saturday. Then what you will say? It is wrong, isn't it? It is varying. It will change. It is changing with respect to time. Is it clear, children? Okay. Then we will say it is not a mathematical statement. Mathematical statement means that answer, the reply you are giving will not vary. It will not vary. Okay, it is independent of the time, place. Okay, it is independent of the time, place, person and all. Okay, so that is what we call it as statement. Mathematical statement. So a meaningful sentence only, but it gives a, that answer will be same at the time, we call it a statement. Look at here. We read these sentences. We read these sentences. We immediately decide that the first sentence is false and the second one is correct. There is no confusion. Okay, there is no confusion. The answer will be same always. So in mathematics, such sentences are called statements. Now look at the next sentence. Karthik, you have to give the answer. Women are more intelligent than men. What will be your answer? Women are more intelligent than men. Karthik, what you will say?
Not true and not false.
Okay. What about Annette?
Same only.
Same. Okay. Sometimes we say it is okay. Sometimes it is not. Isn't it? So it will vary. Some persons will be agreeing. Some of them will say no. Men are having more. Men are more intelligent. Isn't it? So it some. Okay, some people will disagree. So this state sentence, we cannot say whether it is true or false. So this means the sentence is ambiguous. It is doubtful. Such a sentence is not acceptable as a sentence in mathematics. Is it clear? Is it clear? So what is the sentence? A sentence is called a mathematically acceptable statement if it is either true or false, but not both. We should get and will be getting the exact one answer. If I say it today or tomorrow, whatever it may be, it is sentence. Okay, sentence means we should get the correct one. Only one answer should be there. It will not be changing at all. So a sentence is called a mathematically acceptable statement if it is either true or false, but not both. Look at the next one. 2 plus 2 makes 4. 2 plus 2 equals 4. Is it a statement or not? Tell me, children. Is it true or false? 2 plus 2.
True.
True. The next one. Sum of two positive integers. Is it a statement? Okay, that is first one is true. First one is true. 2 plus 2 equals 4. So it is true. Is it a statement? Is it a mathematical statement?
No, ma'am.
It is a statement.
No.
Why? Why you are saying no, Shubham? 2 plus 2 is 4, isn't it? Whenever we are saying the answer, 2 plus 2 is 4. Is it true? If I say it tomorrow also, it is correct. The answer will not change. If I say the answer after 1 week and after 1 month, 2 plus 2 equals 4. Suppose I am going to, suppose I am shifting my place to Chennai and from there if I say 2 plus 2 is 4, will it change? 2 plus 2 is equal to 4, isn't it? Annette? Therefore, is it a statement or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it clear? Shubham, is it okay? Can you understand? 2 plus 2 is 4. Whether the answer is okay, every time
yes,
the answer is true. Okay, it is not at all
okay,
changing.
Ma'am.
It is not a statement. In that case, we will say it is not a statement. Is it clear? Suppose I say Karthik is a mathematics graduate. Then one person is there. We are identifying the person and we are saying. So answer will be either yes or no. But if I say he is a graduate, he is a doctor. Who is a doctor? We don't know who is that person. We are just mentioning he, isn't it? So it may refer to any person. So such cases we call it is not a mathematically accepted statement. Similarly, suppose I am saying, going Kashmir from here is far away, or Kashmir is far away from this place. Is it a statement? Kashmir is far away from this place. Okay? Is it a statement? Aditya Satyan, what will be your answer? No. Why?
No.
No, why?
Because it can vary.
It can vary from this place. I am saying this is this place. Suppose I am saying Kashmir is far away from Chennai. Kashmir is far away from Mala. If I say means it is true, you will be saying yes, it is true. But here I am giving the verse and using the word this place. This place means which place? Okay, it's not sure. We are not certain about the place. So in that case, we say it is not a statement. Okay, so look at this. She is a mathematics graduate. Kashmir is far from here. Look at this. Next one. There are 40 days in a month. Is it a statement? There are 40 days in a month.
No.
Is it a statement? Is it true or false? I'm not asking. Is it a statement or not? Is it a mathematical statement? What is the answer? There are 40 days in a month. What will be your answer?
No.
No, false. Isn't it? No, not possible. Isn't it? So, answer will be the same everywhere. At any time if I ask. So, it is a statement. It is a statement. We know that maximum number of days in a month is 31. Therefore, it is a statement. Although we are not mentioning the month there, there are 40 days in a month is not possible. It is false. So, it is a statement. Look at the next one. Some examples are given. Let's go through the example and exercise question. You have to tell, give the reason. Okay. Read the question. Example 1. Check whether the following sentences are statements. Give reason. Look at the first one. 8 is less than 6. What is your answer? 8 is less than 6. Is it a statement? Is it a statement?
No, it's not a statement.
Aishwarya, I think you are not getting what is meant by statement. What is meant by statement? What is meant by statement? You should get either answer is true or false. 8 is less than 6. It is false, isn't it? We'll be getting only one answer for it. Therefore, it is a statement. Is it clear? If it is false, it is not a statement. It does not mean like that. 8 is less than 6. Always it is false. Only one answer is there. Therefore, it is a statement. Look at the next one. Every set is a finite set. Every set is a finite set. Is it true? Is it true? If you take any set is a finite set. Is it true? It is false, isn't it? Every set is finite, it is not possible, isn't it? So it is false. So it is a statement. Look at the next one. The sun is a star. We have learned it in our lower classes. It is a truth, isn't it? It is a general truth. Sun is a star. Therefore, it is a statement. Look at the next one. Mathematics is fun. Is it a statement? Is it a statement? Mathematics is fun.
Yes.
Yes. Few of you will be saying yes. Okay. Few of them will say. First, few of them, Max is a horrible, terrible subject, isn't it? And then what they will say? No, it is not at all fun. So it will vary from one person to another person. Is that no? Therefore, it is not a statement. If everywhere, if from each and every person, if we get the same answer, if it is yes, then it is a statement. Look at the next one. There is no rain without clouds. There is no rain without clouds. What is your answer?
Yes, it is a statement.
Yes, it is a statement. Okay, it is a truth. What about the next one? How far is Chennai from here? Is it a statement? How far is Chennai from here? Tomlin, give the answer, Tomlin. How far?
Ma'am, no.
No. Why? Why it is not a statement? Are you able to understand? From here.
Yes, ma'am.
From here means that suppose I'm standing here and if I ask, it is from Mala. It is, it will vary with respect to place, isn't it? It will vary from one place to another place. The answer is not same. Therefore, it is not a statement. From here, where? Where is the place? That one we don't know. So it is not a statement. Is it clear, children? Is it okay? So now do this exercise. Now do the exercise 14.1. Do this one. Which of the following sentences are statements? Give reasons for your answer. You have to give the reason. Is it statement or not? You have to give reason. Okay, children. Second question. Second question you have done. Okay, I'll do one thing. Children, for the time being, you read the question and answer it. After this class, I'll send the copy of it. You can write it in your notebook. You can write the questions with answers in your notebook. Okay, now no need to write. Okay, I'll send these questions. Okay, now read it and tell me the answer. No need to copy it now. Just you understand what is it. Yes, one by one start doing. You start with Aparna. Let us start with Aparna. First one, what is the answer?
Ma'am, no. It is not a statement.
There are 35 days in a month. Answer is? What is the answer?
No.
False. Answer will be always false.
Statement.
Answer will be always false, isn't it? Therefore, it is a statement. Yes or no? Can you give a month with the 35 days? Not possible. Is it true or false? Aparna, the question is, answer is it true or is it false? It's not a matter. Whether the answer will vary, that is the thing you have to check. The answer will vary. There are 35 days in a month. What will be your answer?
No, ma'am, it will not vary.
It will not vary. If it will not vary, then it is a statement.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, earlier the same model question only someone said it is, okay? There are 40 days in a month. It is a statement. We will not be able to find it. It is false. What about the next one? Annette.
No, ma'am, it's not a statement.
Why?
Because it is different for different people.
Very good. It will vary from one person to another person. Third one, Aditya Satyan.
It is a statement.
It is a statement. Why? Why it is a statement?
Because anyway, when we add this both, it will be greater than 10 and the answer is always same.
Isn't it same? Very good. So answer is same. So, and we will get it. The number is 12, which is greater than 10. So, it is true. Every time it is true, therefore, it is a statement. Now, once again, Aparna, answer the fourth one.
Yes, ma'am, it is a statement.
The square of a number is an even number. Answer is false, isn't it? When you square a number, will it be getting an even number? No, isn't it?
No.
5 square is 25. So it is false.
It is.
Answer is false. Every time the answer is false. So therefore it is a statement.
Statement.
Now, the next one. Tomlin. Tomlin.
Yes, ma'am.
Fifth one. What is the answer? Read the sentence and give the answer.
The sides of a quadrilateral have equal length. False.
False.
Statement.
It is false, isn't it? Quadrilateral means we can't say it is. Okay, if it is given isosceles triangle, in isosceles triangle, the sides are equal. That is also a statement, isn't it? No. Yes or no? It is false. Isosceles means we need only, yes?
Now, fourth one, how is it a statement?
The square of a number is an even number. When you square a number, will you be getting an even number?
Ma'am, 7 square is 49.
Yes. Answer is false.
Should be, it's not a statement.
No, see, that's what I'm saying. It is whether the answer is true or false. Whether you'll get both, then it is not a statement. What do you say? The statement is wrong, isn't it? This statement, this sentence is wrong. The square of a number is even number is not possible, isn't it? Is or no?
Yes, ma'am.
That is what we mean here. The square of a number is an even number. That is not possible. When you square a number, surely you will get even number. It is not possible. It is false. That is wrong. Therefore, it is a statement. We are not getting confused with that. We know it is wrong. Is it clear, Aditya? Is it Aditya Satyan? Yes? See, here the thing is, okay, don't think that we are getting false. If the sentence is wrong, then it is not a statement. It does not mean like that. If the sentence is wrong, okay, the concept is wrong, the answer is false. That means it is a statement. It is a sentence with the wrong answer. That is a sentence which is given wrong. But it is mathematically it is a statement. Is it clear? Is it okay, Anila Mohanan? Huh?
Yes.
What about the next one? Check the next one. So next one. Aditya Satyan, answer this one.
Ma'am, which one?
Sixth one.
This is not a statement.
Why it is not a statement? Answer this question, isn't it? This question, it will change after some time. So when I do the sixth question, answer this question means the answer will be six. After some time when I say answer this question, so the next option is seven. So it will be changing. Therefore it is this. This means which one? Which is, it is not clearly mentioned. It is not clearly given which one. Suppose it is given answer the fifth question. Then it is a statement. Here it is given answer this question. Which one? It is not clearly given. It is not clearly referred. So it is not a statement. Now next, Anila Mohanan, answer the seventh one.
It is a statement.
That is a statement. But what about the answer of that one?
It's false.
It's false. Is it clear? Similar type only. Earlier we did one. Answer is false, but it is a statement. Next, Karthik, eighth one.
The sum of all interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. It's a statement.
It is a statement. Okay. Then, ninth one, Shubham. Shubham, ninth one. Shubham? Shubham? Okay, Tomlin, give the answer, Tomlin, ninth one.
Ma'am, statement. Not statement.
Not a statement, why?
Might may vary.
Today, okay, the place is changing, day is changing, time is varying, it is varying. Therefore, it is not a statement. Next one. All real numbers are complex numbers. Complex numbers you have not learned. Okay, when you take root of negative numbers, you will be getting complex numbers. That is not there for you. Okay, so that one, that question you can leave because it is not there. Okay, so now is it okay? What is meant by statement? Mathematical statement, sentences which give the answer either true or false, but not both. Okay, if I say it is correct, or if you say it is wrong, then it is a statement. Otherwise, one day if you say yes and at next day if you say no, or at one place if you say yes and another place if you are saying no, then it is not a statement. Is it okay? Now the next one. Now, new statements from old. What is given here? Negation of a statement. Delhi is a city. What is the negation? What is the negation of the city? Negation. The denial of the statement only we call it as negation of the statement. We are denying it. Okay? Actually, this is introduced by George Boole. Boolean algebra, you'll be learning this when you go for higher studies. Boolean algebra, Boolean. Yes or no? Okay, this is given by George Boole, an English mathematician. Okay, from okay, he is linking both English and Max here. Now, what is negation of a statement? Negation means it is the denial of the statement, isn't it? Now, Delhi is the city. What is the negation? Yes, tell me, children. What is the negation? Delhi is a city. So, what is the negation?
Delhi is not a city.
Yes, that's all. It is, Delhi is not a city. So, that's what we call it as negation. Okay, if you want, you can elaborate more rightly like this. Delhi is not a city. That one simply we can write like this, or look at here, it is false that New Delhi is a city. Okay, so if, okay, this is the, if P is a statement, negation of P, not P. When you write the statements, okay, when you write the negation, you have to check, is it correctly applied? Everyone in Germany speaks German. What is the negation here? Everyone in the Germany speaks German. What is the negation of the statement? Everyone in Germany speaks German. What will be the negation? No one in Germany speaks German. Is it true? No, then?
Not all in Germany speaks German.
That means you can find at least one person in Germany who will not be speaking German. There exists at least one person in Germany who will not speak German. Okay, not all. Okay, not all means we are using, there is at least one person. There is at least one. So look at here, the denial of the statements tells that not everyone in Germany speaks German. This does not mean that no person in Germany, okay, if we say no person speaks Germany means it goes entirely wrong. Here what do you have to say? At least one person in Germany does not speak German. Okay, in the next period we can continue, children. Next, okay, one more period we have, that time we will continue with this. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.